Earth has a lot going for it, but there's one thing a bunch of other planets have that ours doesn't, and that's a ring. I mean, Saturn has 7 and we've got none? But that may not always have been true. There are signs that Earth had its own bling once, and we just missed out on seeing it by a few 100 million years. It wasn't just a cool decoration either. This ancient ring could have been connected with one of the biggest leaps of biodiversity in our planet's history, meaning it helped make Earth what it is today. For a long time, we used to think rings were just Saturn's thing, but they're actually pretty common in our solar system. All 4 of our giant planets have them, and there are hints that Mars had a ring once too. But for whatever reason, we didn't have any evidence of rings closer to the sun than that. Until a team of scientists in Australia picked up on something funny. They've been trying to understand one of the most tumultuous times in Earth's history, called the Ordovician period, which began around 485 million years ago. And there was a lot happening back then. Tectonic plates were on the move. Carbon dioxide levels shot up to multiple times what they are today. Sea levels got so high that almost all of what's now North America was underwater. And then, out of nowhere, temperatures plunged, leading to a lot of Earth freezing over. As you can imagine, there were big things happening with living things, too. At this point, our planet had just gone through the Cambrian explosion, which is when the tree of life hit a growth spurt. And if the Cambrian is when we got the branches, the Ordovician is when they started to fill in. So in the midst of all this geological turmoil, new species were exploding into existence. Basically, every modern fish and marine invertebrate traces its origin back to the Ordovician, making this one of the most important periods of biodiversification in the history of our planet. The big question has always been, what happened? One intriguing clue is that the explosion of new life happened right around the same time that Earth was bombarded by a sudden shower of space rocks. We can still see remains of these meteorites and the craters they made in the fossil record. They're thought to be pieces of an asteroid that broke up in the asteroid belt 466 million years ago. And researchers have hypothesized that all these meteorites wreaked havoc on existing ecosystems, forcing organisms to evolve into new life forms. Others suggested that dust from the meteorites blocked out sunlight, which then caused the temperature to plunge. Either way, the general consensus was that a run-in with this asteroid's debris somehow stirred things up on Earth and triggered the rapid diversification of life. But there were some issues with the idea that the breakup of a far-off asteroid caused the sudden bombardment during the Ordovician. One big sticking point was the fact that there's no sign that Mars or the Moon got a shower of meteors at the same time, which seemed to suggest that whatever happened, it was localized just to Earth, which led to someone on that Australian team developing a hunch that a big chunk of that asteroid had broken up a lot closer to Earth. And to explain why that matters, we need to talk about something called the Roche limit. When you have a small object like an asteroid approaching a large object like a planet, there's an invisible line between the two of them that's determined by their relative gravitational forces. Every planetary body is basically held together by its own gravity. So when the larger object starts to pull on the little one, there's a tug of war between those two centers of gravity, and the closer they are, the harder the big object can pull. And if they get too close, that big object can essentially disintegrate the smaller one, piece by piece. So the Roche limit is the line that determines how close is too close, so to speak. And objects crossing over that Roche limit is actually how lots of planets got their rings, by demolishing big chunks of rock that get too close to them. And now here's a little chunk of information from one of our sponsors.
Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this SciShow video. Brilliant is an online learning platform that helps you build real knowledge in just minutes a day, and it's good for you. Learning a little every day can help with your personal and professional growth. And Brilliant really does have enough lessons for you to make a daily habit of adding more learning to your life. I'm talking thousands of lessons in a variety of subjects, from data analysis to AI to engineering. You can find them all at brilliant.org/SciShow, the QR code, or the link in the description. That link gives you 20% off an annual premium Brilliant subscription, and you'll get the first 30 days for free.
So in light of all that, the team of researchers started to wonder if a big chunk of that far-off asteroid might have wandered too close to Earth. If that did happen, Earth's gravity could have ripped the asteroid to shreds, creating our planet's very own ring. It was a wild idea, but not impossible. Remember what I said about how Mars used to have a ring? We think the same thing happened to Mars, and then that ring debris unshredded and formed one of Mars's moons. And if that same thing happened to our planet, the objects forming the ring could have gradually fallen to Earth, explaining this mysterious bombardment during the Ordovician period. One way to test this idea is to look at where the impact craters were relative to the equator. See, because planets bulge out a bit around their equators, that's usually the best place for a ring to form. So they needed to map all of the impact craters from this time period, but also needed to do that on a projection of where the continents were back then, because continental drift is a thing. And the results were mind-blowing. They showed that most of the craters dotted land that would have been within just 30 degrees of the equator. That suggests that meteors weren't just falling on Earth willy-nilly in a shower of debris hailing from the asteroid belt. It seemed like they'd fallen out of a ring that was circling the equator. This hypothetical ring probably didn't survive for too long, geologically speaking. It formed around 466 million years ago and may have lasted about 40 million years before burning through the atmosphere piece by piece and falling to Earth. Aside from being an awesome piece of bling, this ring made of shredded asteroid would have helped steer the evolution of our planet and every living thing on it. It would have cast a shadow on whichever hemisphere was in winter, making things even colder. At the same time, it would have reflected light onto the summer hemisphere, making summer even hotter. Meanwhile, dust kicked up by meteorite impacts would have blocked some sunlight, cooling the whole planet, and possibly explaining Earth's sudden freeze. And all the environmental changes may have been the key to the explosion in diversity that came along at this time. The increased seasonality, hotter summers, colder winters, and average temperature shifts, all that creates lots of new extremes and more distinctions between habitats. When the range of temperatures expanded, that meant that there were all sorts of new niches for living things to adapt and radiate into, which would put pressure on all those critters to diversify into the groups that we see today. Unfortunately, we came along about 400 million years too late to know what life was like on a ringed planet or to see a glowing ring up in the sky. But if this ring really did exist, we just might owe our existence to the biodiversification it helped set in motion. So it was fashionable and very functional. Win-win.